around so much, just trying to catch up with people in the off scene as well. That's maybe another reason.
Can
go see as many people as I can, and that's it.
Colin, great stuff. Appreciate the time and best luck here the rest of the season here in Ottawa.
Appreciate it, AJ. Thanks.
It's Colin Falve, who's now my new favorite member of Ottawa Fury FC, because he cheers for the right club, Richard. He cheers for the one and only Newcastle United.
I'm quite happy for you, AJ. You've actually found somebody who plays on this team, who's a fan of the club that you cheer for. I would point out...
We suffer together.
I should point out that the two guys that he mentioned about who he really likes so well for Newcastle are both middle-aged. Shearer and Ginola.
That's fine. That's why I became a Newcastle fan as well, especially Alan Shearer.
Alan Shearer is one of the best ever.
All right. When we come back, we'll have a look at the starting 11 for both sides, and then it will be time for kickoff here as Ottawa Fury FC take on Atlanta Silverbacks on TSN 1200.
There's a zillion colors out there.
3 minutes.
Choosing the right one that'll work best on your walls is the hardest part. The team at Preston Hardware can make your walls come alive with Benjamin Moore paint. They know paint inside and out, and they have all the latest high-tech paint gadgets, so if you bring them a picture or color sample, they'll match it. If you need paint or painting supplies, come see the Benjamin Moore collection at Preston Hardware, Ottawa's largest Benjamin Moore dealer.
Service. Selection.
Into Sports, the soccer superstore on Merivale Road. Their goal is to serve, inform, and inspire those who share a passion for the beautiful game. Into Sports carries everything from cleats to jerseys and from shin pads to balls. Soccer isn't just a sport, it's a way of life. So dress the part.
Go, 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 go.
Into Sports, 1558 Merivale Road and intosports.ca.
Head to DQ for the Flamethrower Cheeseburger $6 meal deal. You get a fiery cheeseburger with signature flamethrower sauce, jalapeno bacon, and pepper jack cheese. Also, a sundae to beat the heat with the sweet. They're giving you the fire and the extinguisher all in one meal. Plus fries and a drink, all for just $6. Head to DQ at 1451 Richmond Road and 2200 Montreal Road in Ottawa to experience the Flamethrower Cheeseburger $6 meal deal. This is fan food, not fast food.
Jeff Hopper with Alan Forget from Sobeys. Quick question, Alan.
Go for it, Jeff.
Are there gardens on the roofs of Sobeys stores?
Not the last time I checked.
Just lost a bet. I told my wife I thought that Sobeys produce is so fresh, you must grow it on site.
Not quite, but we
you
do
got 3 minutes here on Yes and A, creature.
Yeah, I added a minute.
Perfect.
Doing laundry for the next week.
Jeff, I've met your wife. Stop betting against her. She's smarter than you.
Sobeys, better food for all, and the freshest produce in town.
I'm calling him Seuss. I don't care.
Stittsville and Trimmett.
It looks like Seuss. I bet it's Seuss.
It's Aaron LeBar from Popeye Supplements.
It's not gonna be
Imagine
Seuss.
If your energy level stayed high throughout the day without caffeine. It is possible.
He looks
Progressive
like a
Veggie
Seuss
Greens
today.
Is a 60-ingredient super
looks like
green
Seuss.
Food
I'm
blend,
calling him
and
Seuss.
One serving is equivalent to six to eight servings of vegetables. It can also help detoxify your body and boost your immune system. Popeye's offers a variety of nutritional supplements to improve your health and your life. Visit one of Popeye's six Ottawa locations or visit PopeyesCanada.com.
How come there's no Zeus on Brazil?
The track.
They had Socrates. There's no Zeus.
It doesn't care about the restrictions and boundaries.
Hulk
to
Zeus.
Place upon you. Just because you
Socrates. That's one of the great names in all of sports.
The
right
track
now.
Is the right track. Name. It doesn't get any special treatment. Special Olympics World Summer Games. July 25th to August 2nd. Followers and Special Olympics. Don't fear.
All right, let's go.
Home of the Fury. Ottawa Fury FC Soccer on TSN 1200. The match starts now.
Welcome back inside TD Place. AJ Jakubek alongside Richard Starnes. And the crowd getting into this one here right now is... Here, the supporters groups right off the hop. Stony Monday Riot, Fury Ultras, Bytown Boys making noise. Ottawa Fury FC with a chance to go top of the league with 3 points tonight against Atlanta Silverbacks. Here is The starting 11 first for the visiting Silverbacks. It will be Stuart Seuss, the starting keeper. The back three, they're going 3-5-2. Mohamed Isahaku, along with Simon Mensing and Rashawn McKenzie. In midfield, they've got Paul Black, Michael Reed, Michal Mravec, Junior Burgos, and Kosuke Kimura. And the two strikers up top, Pedro Mendez and Jaime Chavez. For Ottawa, Romuald Pezer gets the start again. Leads the league with 8 clean sheets on the season. Mason Trafford, Colin Falvey, Rafael Alves, Ryan Richter, the back four. 2 changes in midfield, Phil Davies and Mauro Eustachio in for Julian De Guzman and Sinisa Ubi-Perapovic, who is on the bench. Richie Ryan, the captain, starts in central midfield. And up front, Tom Heineman with goals in his last 3 matches is in the middle again, flanked by Oliver on the right and Canadian Carl Howarth on the left.
Interesting, interesting setup. Just changed the 2 guys up front. They've given Davies a chance to show himself for the first time as a starter since he broke his arm. And I think probably he's trying. I think Mark DeSantos is doing his level best to make sure that nobody gets too tired here. I'm not surprised to see, although I suppose he won't like it, Sinisa Ubi-Perapovic, he likes to play every minute of every game. But you've got to be sensible with your players when you've got that many games. 3 games in 8 days, 3 games in 8 days, something like that.
Yeah.
That's pretty tough, especially when it's on this harder surface than grass. It's tough on the body.
Referee today is Francis Latulippe. The assistants, Elias Orfa and Gianni Faccini. And the fourth official is Chris Grabus. The Silverbacks with their white shirts, the red and black stripes, white shorts and white socks. They'll move from left to right. Actually, looks like they're gonna change things around. Even the keepers were on the wrong side. And so Atlanta's gonna go right to left here as Romuald Pezer makes the run across to the other side. Fury wearing their black kits, the home tops with the red and white stripes, black shorts, black socks, and they will move from left to right here in the opening 45 minutes.
Interesting to see how they do set up the Silverbacks, because they are playing with 3 at the back and they're playing 5 through the middle, but 2 of the guys who are playing in the midfield actually are first and foremost, Kimura and Black are first and foremost defenders, fullback. So we'll see how they work. I think they're quite likely to try and flood the middle of the park.
All right, we are underway. Here's Oliver down the left as Fury gained possession in the first minute. Oliver with a cross into the Atlanta penalty area, and quickly it's headed clear by Simon Mensing. Fury with possession, 45 yards out. Ryan Richter back inside the Ottawa half for Rafael Alves. In the team of the week in the NASL this week, scored the opening goal in that 4-2 win over Indy 11 on a set piece. The central defender out of Brazil. Pezer launches this forward past the halfway line. Heineman went up for it. Mensing won the ball for Atlanta. Fury trying to get it back. Eustachio in there in the center circle, and he does win it to Richie Ryan. Now Phil Davies, the Canadian, with his first start of the NASL season. 4 Canadians in the lineup today. Carl Howarth, Mauro Eustachio, Phil Davies, and Mason Trafford. So that's always good for the development of our Canadian national team when you see Canadians playing on Canadian clubs.
Yep.
A novel concept, Rich.
Very, very novel.
Someone needs to tell Vancouver and Montreal how that works.
They don't understand that. They don't understand it. And actually, sadly, they don't appear to care, which doesn't help the development of the game in this country. But both the Canadians who are on the field this afternoon are on the field not because they're Canadians, but because they deserve to be. And the more you can play them, Eustachio needs to play. He really needs to play. He's developing really quickly and has tremendous potential. It makes you wonder why he's not really being recognized on a national scale, playing for any national teams on any sort of regular basis. He's a young man of great potential.
Yeah, you look at the Pan Am games, they could have used a player of his caliber. an under 23 side, and Eustachio 21. And
they were bad, actually. They really looked
awful.
When
you look at the difference between Mauro Eustachio and the Canadian captain on the senior side, Julian de Guzman, I mean, it's not really a huge gap.
I don't think so either. So I don't think so. He's got that same calmness about him, and that is really useful as of a defensive midfielder.
Third minute here at TD Place, 0-0. Reminder that old goals in today's match brought to you by Athens Rugs, and here's a free kick given Ottawa's way as Mason Trafford is fouled, and we're going to see the first yellow card coming.
Yeah, I think that was a foot up into his kneecap. There, bang, right into the back of his kneecap. Nowhere near the ball. I think he'll be back up and back in the game, but that was not a good tackle.
So a yellow card here to Pedro Mendes, the Brazilian striker.
Who's complaining. Don't ask me why, but he's complaining. And just some players are like that. They complain whenever something happens that they don't approve of. In that case, he was wrong.
Silverbacks in possession. Far touch line, Oliver able to knock it out for an Atlanta throw. Silverbacks trying to make their way in the Atlanta market. MLS coming to Atlanta. And unlike Minnesota United, where it's the same ownership group moving from NASL to MLS, it's a different scenario. So we'll see how long they can make a go of it when Atlanta goes into MLS in 2017.
Yeah, but it could be. It's quite likely that the NASL.
Ooh, here's a ball in for Howarth. Gets a shot away, and Seuss able to come out and stop that with his thigh. And it goes out for a throw. So Carl Howarth with the first shot on target here in the match, just on a long ball that bounced in behind a couple of Atlanta defenders, and Howarth got to that first. Ball forward from Mason Trafford, and a little miscommunication with him and Tom Heineman, and that goes to the keeper, Seuss.
Yep, I think Seuss is, I think Heineman, Carl Howarth did the right thing. He tried to chip him, but Seuss is, he's a big man. He's 6'6". He's a terrifically tall man. So not sure that that's the easiest thing to do. And he came off his line very hard.
Looks a little like Seuss with that stature he's got in there.
Maybe we should pronounce his name Seuss. I think it sounds better.
I do too. How did we have a Socrates and no Seuss, by the way, on Brazil?
Well,
how did that
right.
happen?
I haven't a clue. You tell me. I think the name,
I mean,
Socrates.
A Hulk.
Oh, no.
I love those early 80s Brazilian teams with Zico and Socrates and Junior.
Yeah.
His big afro.
I don't think Hulk's a pretty philosophical name. Doesn't sound like that, does it, really? Let's face it. But I think Socrates is the neatest name in soccer. Oh, there you go. And he was a terrific player.
6 minute, 0-0 here at TD Place. Atlanta in possession as they work it wide right for Paul Black. Long ball towards Chavez, goes down as he chests it down. He certainly didn't look to be touched.
No.
Good non-call by the referee, Latulipe, as Ottawa plays a long ball towards Heineman. It's headed back by Mensing to the keeper, Seuss, and he will roll it forward. Mravec, central midfield. Now to Michael Reed, and a free kick given against Tom Heineman, taken quickly by the Silverbacks.
There were one or two early touches on Heineman that were rough and tough, just like happened to him on the weekend, but he's not a man to back off, and if he's he'll be in there making sure that they realize that he can give as good as he gets.
Mravec plays it wide right for Rashawn McKenzie. Ball deflects into the middle. Junior Burgos. A wide ball towards Paul Black. Played last year in Cheltenham. League Two in England. Taken away from him by Richter, and this is going to be played out for another Atlanta throw in the eighth minute, no score.
He was trying to look like, Black was trying to look like a winger, but actually he's a fullback, so struggling to beat a man on the outside. Don't think he's got the pace for that.
Black with the throw-in. Out of Michael Reed. Back to the central defender and captain Simon Mensing, the German. Center circle, he moves it wide right, Rashawn McKenzie. Again, a back three for Atlanta. As they pack the midfield with five, here's Paul Black, left flank, plays it forward. Here's Pedro Mendez with a cross, comes back, long shot, and that one misses from Michael Reed, who was in a good shooting position, 20 yards out, but didn't get much on it, and it goes wide of the near post for a goal kick.
Complaint or two there about from Colin Confalvi. Thought there was an offside there coming up that side, but you know, he pulled it back, he beat the man, he pulled it back from the byline. Bad shot effort, because he had a clear sight of goal from the edge of the penalty area.
Goal kick taken by Pizarro in the ninth minute. Waiting our first goal, a shove here as Heineman is given a shove from Michael Reed, and this will be a free kick just inside the Atlanta half for Fury FC.
Seems like business as usual for Tommy Heineman. He gets a lot of it, but get a lot of the shoves in the back, and he seems to take it, and he lifts, and he gets free kicks for it, so good for him.
Richie Ryan takes this free kick, and referee wants him to take it again.
What for? Not 10 yards, maybe? Yeah. Not 10 yards.
So a warning here for Junior Burgos, the El Salvador native.
Simon Mensing, the German, played quality soccer in Scotland for Hamilton Academicals and Livingston. So he's good. He's a good player. He's not. He's no spring chicken, but he's tall and he's solid. Not sure how quick he is. Somebody with a bit of pace might be able to make him look a bit silly.
Silverbacks work it back to their central defender, Mensing. Wide right for Rashawn McKenzie. Now Mensing. Wide left for Isahaku. Mohamed Isahaku. Into the Ottawa half. Michael Reed, wide right for Rashawn McKenzie. Able to keep it in play, gets it back for Mravec, the Slovak. Now Mensing.
Quite a bit of shadow boxing going on here, AJ. Nobody's committing too many men too far forwards. Fury included. So, but it looks like they're playing, that the Silver Blacks are playing 3-2, 3-3. Is that right? 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. No, three, can't be right. 3-2-2-3. I mean, it's a strange looking setup. Suddenly they're pushing five men forward. But only three men at the back. And when you've got Mensing, who's not quick, that's a bit risky, I feel.
Ball flicked on there by Michael Reed, and it comes back to Mensing in the center circle. He'll play this over the top. Falvey trying to deal with this. He gets ahead on it and knocks it to ground, but Atlanta with possession outside the penalty area. Burgos plays it wide right, but way out of the reach of Kimura, the Japanese winger, and that will be a throw-in for Ottawa on that errant Atlanta pass. 12th minute, 0-0.
Yeah, haven't watched Kimura before. He's the first Japanese-born player in the NASL, and I don't know how quick he is, and he also is billed as a defender, but is playing wide right, wide left. No, wide right.
Ball stays in. Atlanta able to keep it alive on the touchline, but good challenge here by Colin Falvey. Wins the ball, gets it to his Irish compatriot, Richie Ryan. Now Eustachio wide left for Mason Trafford, and he'll play it to the halfway line for Carl Howarth. Good ball, chested down, quick little 1-2. Oliver for Howarth, back to Oliver down the left. 35 yards out, the Brazilian into the middle, Mauro Eustachio. Wide right for Ryan Richter. Richter trying to cut into the middle. Lays it off for Eustachiou, and his ball misses Phil Davies down the right, and this will be a goal kick for the Silverbacks in the 13th minute.
Bad execution by Eustachiou, but the idea was perfect. He just hit it too hard.
Silverbacks push forward now. It's Mravec. Wide right, Rashawn McKenzie. Back for Michael Reed in the middle. Wide left for Paul Black. Now to Issahaku. Mensing, wide right. Rashawn McKenzie, short of the halfway line. Kimura. Back to McKenzie. Back into the middle, Mensing. Atlanta very deliberate in their approach. Reed, wide right for McKenzie. Back to Reed. Center circle. Pushes this forward. Good challenge here by Alves. Ottawa wins the ball. Eustachiou. The ball intended for Oliver. And Atlanta get it back. Comes all the way to the keeper, Seuss. And it's moved into the middle for Mravec. Leaves it there for the central defender, Simon Mensing. Captain, wide left to Sahaku. Fury win possession here. It's Eustachiou with a run, 40 yards out. Lays it off wide left for Oliver. He'll play the cross into the penalty area looking for Carl Howarth. It's headed away. Davies wins it back. Now to Eustachiou, wide right, Ryan Richter, 25 yards out. Richter. Quick little 1-2 for Davies. Now Eustachiou, good ball down the right. Howarth near the byline, trying to get the cross in, chips it into the air. Not a good ball from Howarth, and it's headed clear, but Fury get it back. Eustachiou, 25 yards out for the captain, Richie Ryan. Wide right, Ryan Richter. And he's almost forced back, but able to fake out the Atlanta defender. Plays it forward for Phil Davies. 20 yards out with a cross in. Getting his toe on it, Mensing. Able to push it out of the penalty area. Referee not biting on Oliver falling there. The Brazilian striker for Ottawa. But Eustachiou wins it back. 20 yards out. Mauro Eustachiou lays it off. And Eustachiou has been winning balls, but his passing has been a little off here in the opening 15 minutes. Is just another opportunity there. Fury forced all the way back into their own half.
Yeah, he'd have done better than that occasion to take a shot, even though he was outside the box. He had room, and he put the ball behind.
There's a ball in for Tom Heinemann, chests it down, left-footed shot, and that one just misses high. Boy, Heinemann took that well, just couldn't finish, but that shows a player of great confidence. Tom Heinemann has scored in his last three matches.
Yep, you're quite right. Earlier on, and earlier in the spring season, he'd have tried to take an extra couple of touches and beat the man and bring it down. No, he took a good poke at it. And here's something that I think they should be keeping a close eye on. If you watch Mensing, he is not quick. And if he pushes himself too far up the field, the little chips over his head, he's got just about anybody can beat him for pace.
Rafael Alves with a clearing header here, but Atlanta keeps it alive. Now the cross, and Alves deals with that. Plays it out of touch. It'll be an Atlanta throw inside the Ottawa half, 17th minute. Still scoreless here at TD Place.
The back four need to settle down a bit, AJ. There's too many rash clearances. They need to make sure that they get themselves properly settled.
Richie Ryan back for Colin Falvey, just inside the 18-yard box for Fury FC. Wide left, Mason Trafford. Now to Falvey. He's pressured here, so pushes this forward, flicked on by Oliver. Winning possession here is Issahaku, and the Silverbacks work it into the middle for Simon Mensing. Alves able to get a touch on it as it was shipped forward near the edge of the Ottawa penalty area, but comes back to Issahaku just inside the Ottawa half. Now Issahaku making a run into the middle. Four black shirts there, so he moves it wide left for Paul Black. Black now to Michael Reed. Back inside the Atlanta half for Mravec. He'll play it to Mensing. Is Atlanta comfortable just having possession? Far from the Ottawa goal. Rashawn McKenzie to Mensing. Now Mravec. Wide left, Issahaku. Mravec. Wide right, McKenzie. Sends this forward, gets it back just inside the Atlanta half. Moves it into the middle for Mravec. Wide left for Paul Black. Headed away by Ryan Richter. This will be an Atlanta throw. 25 yards away from goal on the near touchline. Paul Black, the Englishman, will take it. Black gets the ball in for Michael Reed. Now for Issahaku. Into the middle for Mravec. Wide right, McKenzie. Now to Kimura, the Japanese winger. Comes back into the middle, Mravec. To Rashawn McKenzie. Now Simon Mensing. Plays it wide left, chested down, won by Richter. Ottawa gains possession. Phil Davies into the middle for Oliver. Center circle, Oliver moves it wide right, Ryan Richter. Back to Oliver. Now to Richter. Forced back to the halfway line. And moves it all the way back into the Ottawa half for Colin Falvey. Wide left, Mason Trafford. Back to Falvey. The Irishman gets it across for his partner in central defense, Brazilian Rafael Alves. Wide right for Richter, loses possession. Black wins it, and Eustáquio with a good hard tackle wins it right back for Fury. Ooh, Davies is knocked down. That looked like it should have been a free kick. If not a yellow card against Issahaku, a hard challenge, and Davies still on the ground. That brought Bruce Grobelaar out of his seat. You don't see him get too emotional on the Ottawa bench, but the former Liverpool keeper not happy with that non-call there as Davies was clearly fouled.
He took his leg out from behind him, just above the knee, and just flattened him. He's a big man too, Issahaku. He's 6'2", and from where I'm sitting, looks about 6'9". But big man, and that was, that really wasn't, and there was no call from the linesman, who wasn't far from it. If my name was Phil Davies, I'd be having a quiet word with the linesman. He's quite close to him at the moment.
Grobelaar would have expected that call to be made in the Merseyside Derby back in the 80s when football was really tough.
Yeah, football was for men. That's not fair. Football's still for men. That it used to be very, very tough, certainly in England.
Everton, Liverpool in the 80s, that was the match.
Oh yeah.
When it came to England, two best sides.
Yeah, people in the mid-80s. People might not know that their grounds are either side of a park. I mean,
Stanley Park.
Yep. One's on one side of Stanley Park. One's on the other side. They're very close together, and Everton fans are Everton fans for life, and Liverpool fans are Liverpool fans for life, and sometimes they differ in the same families, or often. So, and neither will give an inch.
22nd minute here at TD Place, 0-0. Fury FC against Atlanta Silverbacks. Fury win possession here, it's Richie Ryan. Good ball forward, trying to spring Tom Heineman, and he is able to work his way onto it. Now Heineman with a right-footed shot, but he fell. He just lost his footing. Heineman not happy with himself. It's, just bad luck there, and Atlanta gains possession. It's the keeper, Seuss.
Now got mad, but you can see the proof of it then. Right then, he's he has got Mensing beaten for pace. I think that's a dangerous little spot for the for Atlanta. So Silverbacks need to be careful, especially when they've only got three at the back.
Silverbacks working across the back three now into central midfield for Mravec. Wide left for Issahaku. Mravec, wide right, Rashawn McKenzie. Sends this forward to the edge of the penalty area. Rafael Alves wins it for Ottawa. Ball comes forward, Heinemann can't get to it. Mensing ahead for Burgos. Wide left, Paul Black, 35 yards out for the Silverbacks. Into the middle, Mravec. Plays it safe back into the Atlanta half. Issahaku for Chavez. Now to McKenzie. Mravec gets it back from Mensing. Plays it wide right for Rashawn McKenzie. Now to Pedro Mendez. And all the way back into the Atlanta half. Atlanta looks like they're happy to play for 0-0 tonight.
I know. This game actually has not taken off at all yet. And so still not.
Alves called for a foul here for Fury, 35 yards out.
Yeah, still not particularly happy personally with, there seems to be something a little not quite 100% in the back four at the moment. There is a bit of a struggle. And I'm not quite sure where Phil Davis is meant to be playing. Is he meant to be playing wide right, or is he meant to be playing in that role, Ljubi Parifovic role? I can't work it out.
Three-man wall as Burgos will take this free kick. Burgos is going to give it a go, and that is a very poor effort.
I think it's going to bounce onto Bank Street, that one.
Well, it bounced wide of the north side stands. That's how poor that effort was.
Good.
It's close to the PetSmart.
In fact, it's a lost ball. It's in the parking lot, I think.
I can honestly say I could have given a better effort on that free kick than Junior Burgos gave right there, and that's not saying much given the media games we've played here at TD Place.
Yeah, book him again. Number 22, Pedro Mendez. He just hacked Richie Ryan's feet out from under him.
Fifth minute here at TD Place, 0-0. As Fury have possession, Alves plays it back to the keeper, Pazer. Sends this high into the air in the Atlanta half. Header won by the right back for the Silverbacks, Rashawn McKenzie, and now a push called against Falve, and that'll be an Atlanta free kick just inside the Ottawa half. I think that ball has rolled all the way to the Sunset Grill, or maybe even if it took a wide right, it could have hit Local or Joey's, one of the many fine establishments here at OSEG, on that Junior Burgos free kick. Might have been the worst free kick in TD Place history.
I think you're probably right.
Fury in possession here in their own half. Here's Oliver now to Richie Ryan. Not quite Richie Ryan-esque. He had a couple of beauties last week for Ottawa on Sunday against Indy. Fury win a throw. Davies trying to take it quickly, but holds up. And actually he'll leave it for Ryan Richter.
Looks like Kyle Howarth is playing that sort of behind Heinemann role that Sanisha Ulipara-Povich usually produces.
Richter throws this long into the penalty area, and he was able to pick out Phil Davies, but couldn't get a shot away, and it's cleared. Now Mason Trafford for Ottawa for Oliver. Good ball movement here as it's sent into the penalty area for Tom Heinemann. Back out for Carl Howarth. Edge of the 18. It's across towards Oliver, left-footed shot, and a good save by Seuss. And they're going to call a free kick here anyways, I think, against Ottawa Fury FC. Otherwise, it would have been a corner, but that was a nicely taken volley there by Oliver with the left foot.
Excellent effort. Looked like they're suggesting that he was knocked over. Not that it would have made any difference to the shot, but there you go. It was a good effort by Oliver with his left foot. Quite right. And Seuss, showing that he's a really tall man and he went wide and low to put it round the post.
So it wouldn't have counted, but Oliver showing his great skill there. Arguably Ottawa's most naturally gifted goal scorer, led the team with 7 last season. Hasn't been healthy enough to factor in this year, just with the 1 goal in the Amway Canadian Championship against FC Edmonton. Fury FC were looking for a free kick. They don't get it. Now they're going to get this one.
Oh, that's got to be a card. That has to be a card. He's walking away. He knows it's a card. Oh, he just bulldozed him to the ground.
No doubt about that one. Carl Howarth was the player who was fouled, and Michal Mravec, the Slovak, in the book. So that's 2 yellow cards against Atlanta, Pedro Mendez, and now Michal Mravec. And he knew.
He knew. Yeah, he knew. He did it, and he just walked off and kept walking. But that must have knocked the stuffing out of Carl Howarth, who's back up and at it again. This is professional soccer. They know they're going to get some of those.
45 yards out, Richie Ryan straight away will take this. 3 players at the edge of the penalty area as he puts this high into the air, looking to pick out Heinemann, and it was headed away, so past the byline. This will be a corner for Ottawa Fury.
It's rough in there for Heinemann. He gives as good as he's got, as he gets, but he's got at least 2 men ready to shovel into him.
Phil Davies will take this corner. It'll be a right-footed outswinger. 5 players in the penalty area. Davies delivers, headed towards goal, and Seuss able to get a hand on it off that Alves header. Seuss will just throw it out of play with one of his defenders down on the turf, and some attention coming from the Atlanta training staff.
Yeah, he got knocked over and probably trodden on. But that's all part and parcel of what goes on in the middle of the penalty area when corner kicks are up. There's always pushing, there's always shoving. Tough decisions for the referee to make in those circumstances, because it's very often 6 of one, half a dozen of the other.
First minute here at TD Place. Still scoreless between Ottawa Fury FC and Atlanta Silverbacks. Fury looking to move top of the league in the NASL fall table. I always explain it, and I'll explain it every match. Spring champion hosts 1 semifinal game, the fall champion hosts the other, and then the remaining 2 spots in the postseason determined by the overall standings. New York Cosmos won the spring. Ottawa sits 2nd in the fall table, just a point behind leaders FC Edmonton using their game in hand here tonight. So a draw would put them level on points, but below Edmonton on goal difference. Ottawa is +4, Edmonton +5. But nonetheless, right in the mix there in the overall table. Ottawa looking to be in the top 4. And right now they're tied with Minnesota on 18 points for 4th. They are below them on goal difference. So a point would put them in the top 4 in the overall table. A win would actually put them tied for 2nd, but on goal difference, it would put them 4th as well. tied with New York and Carolina. And Carolina is here on Sunday, 3 o'clock start, right here on TSN 1200. So that'll be the third straight home match for Fury FC as they host the Railhawks. Boy, if they could get 4 points from these next two matches, you'd love a win tonight, maybe a point against Carolina. Well, the opposite would be even better. But
we're looking for 6 points, AJ.
Yeah, six, why not?
I did notice in that slightly prolonged stoppage for injury that all the players were called over to the sideline, and Mark DeSantis was giving them, I don't know what he was saying, but it was serious stuff. They haven't really looked particularly sharp so far tonight. We'll wait and see what happens, but it's clear that Carl Howarth is playing that frontal midfield role, not Phil Davies, who's playing wide on the right.
Fury win possession here. Phil Davies winning a ball. It goes down the right towards Heineman. This will be an Ottawa throw in the 34th minute, 0-0. Should mention, cloudy evening, 21 degrees. So pretty comfortable night for both sides here. After a pretty uncomfortable day Sunday against Indy 11 when it was 31 degrees and humidity certainly didn't help the cause either. Here's a long throw from Ryan Richter into the Atlanta penalty area, and it's headed away by Isahaku. Fury gained possession. Richie Ryan plays this wide left, Mason Trafford. Ball into the air. Isahaku heads this but doesn't clear it. It comes back to Ryan Richter. 30 yards out. Richter cuts into the middle, beats two men. Richter still in possession. Plays it into the air, looking to pick out Oliver. It's headed away. But here comes Eustachiou, chests it down, plays it ahead. Phil Davies keeps it in play at the byline with the cross, headed down by Tom Heineman, but easily taken here by the keeper, Seuss. But some good work there by Fury.
Yep, they're looking good when they can get the ball slightly wider and bring the crosses in. There were one or two slight handball-y type complaints, but was pretty soft one. Don't think there was anything wrong there.
Reminder that all goals in today's match brought to you by Athens Rugs. After a goal fest on Sunday against Indy, 4-2 Ottawa winning. Still awaiting our first tonight. Get the sense if Ottawa scores, Atlanta would certainly have to change their approach a little bit.
Yeah, it is very, compared to the last two games we've seen, this is what I would call pedantic. It's slow, it's very slow, and the Fury need to pick it up as well. They look so good when they move quickly and their first time touches. Now they got a chance.
Here they come on the counter in their own half. Richie Ryan, oh, didn't see the man there who took possession away from him as it comes to Junior Burgos. Now wide left, Reed, the ball, and this will go out. And it's offside anyway, so no corner for Atlanta.
Not very fair, as we've only been in for 36 minutes, but I would.
Ooh, Seuss coming out beyond his penalty area, heads this away and has to get back on his line as Fury have it 40 yards out. Richie Ryan, good ball towards Oliver. Into the middle, here's Oliver into the penalty area, right-footed shot, and it's right at the keeper, Seuss. Oh, Oliver taking that pass from Howarth, and he got in good shooting range, just put it right into the arms of the big keeper, Stuart Seuss. And now Trafford fouled hard again. He's taken a couple of hard fouls tonight for Ottawa, the Fury left back.
Yeah.
And it's Mendez again.
Yeah, Mendez has got to be very careful.
He's already got a yellow card for the first one.
Another referee would have given a yellow card for that. I mean, just hacked his legs out, his ankles out from under him. Here's something though, AJ. Oliver's looks dangerous when he gets the ball, doesn't he? And he needs to get more of it. And he needs to be producing those devastating quick runs, which will split a defense that looks suspiciously slow, I believe.
Ball flicked on here by Tom Heineman. Mensing deals with the ball. Trafford in control of it now. His ball intended for Howarth, but McKenzie gets in the way. Howarth trying to win it back. Here's Rashawn McKenzie for Atlanta. Into the middle for Michael Reed. Now to Mohamed Issahaku. Beats one man. And I think he got bailed out there.
I think that was a dive. Yeah. He was feet past the ball before he decided to fall over. That's when the ball had run about 10 feet away from him.
He beat one man, tried to beat a second, got caught in possession.
Yeah.
And
that was I wouldn't have called
it. The referee bailed him out. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
Because Fury would have had it 35 yards from goal.
Yeah.
Right off a bad giveaway. Throw in here for Ottawa towards Tom Heineman. He's able to gain possession. 25 yards out in the Atlanta half. Now to Phil Davies. Back to Ryan Richter. Two defenders on him, and so Richter will play it back inside the Ottawa half. Mauro Iustaku plays this wide, chested down. Trafford now for Falve. Cross for Rafael Alves. We'll push this forward.
That's the ball. No,
ball
it's not quite right now. That's the ball that...
Looking to spring Oliver, but
it's a right
little
ball.
Too much on it.
Right, yeah, exactly right. You could see that Oliver had space out there, and if it had been hit lower and hit a lot flatter, he could have run onto it. He's got the pace to beat the defense.
Here's Mensing now for Atlanta. 40th minute, 0-0. Michael Reed. Halfway line. Cuts to the middle towards the center circle. Now to Mravec. He's on a yellow. Head for Paul Black. Davies able to win the ball. For Ottawa now to Richie Ryan. Into the center circle, Oliver. For Tom Heineman. Right flank. Here's Ryan Richter, beats one defender and just didn't get enough on that pass to spring Davies down the right. Atlanta in possession now. Pedro Mendez comes back to Rashawn McKenzie. Into the middle. Oh, Howarth almost got to that. Iustaku does, and he'll win a free kick for Ottawa just inside the Atlanta half.
There are an awful lot of flying feet coming from the Atlanta men when they're trying to get it put in the tackles. It's not a game for sissies tonight, AJ.
Comes wide left now for Mason Trafford. Loses possession. And here's Burgos for Atlanta. Junior Burgos. On the left from Mohamed Issahaku. Into the middle, Simon Mensing, the captain. Wide right, Rashawn McKenzie. Into the Ottawa half, Kimura. He's caught in possession, Fury have it. As Oliver won that, now Howarth. A good ball wide right for Phil Davies. Davies loses possession, but it does go out for a throw. And he's going to leave this for Ryan Richter, who will
put in the long one, I guess.
Yeah, long one into the box. No, we'll take this short for Davies. Back to Richter. To Davies, near the corner flag. Two defenders on him. Davies back into the middle. Howarth. Quick little 1-2 with Richter. Now to Davies. Ball towards the penalty area, but Michael Reed able to get in the way, and now he's fouled, and this will be a yellow card. And the first against Ottawa, it's going against Carl Howard.
I think that was a little rough. I'm going to get another look at that. I think he maybe did get his ankles. Yeah, he did bring the man down. Because you can't really complain at that, except that it's been happening in the other direction quite a lot more.
Carl Howard, the first Ottawa player in the book. And now Howard needs a little treatment. Well, 43 minutes in, still nil-nil, but the spirits of the supporters groups not dampened, still in full voice.
No, they're getting great support from the fans. But this game, to be quite honest, needs an injection of something. I think the Fury need to make more use of their pace. And the back four, defensively, they look a little more shaky than usual. We come to expect it to look tremendous. And they're looking a little more shaky than usual. There's something missing here, and there we are. Quite like to see Mark Vasantas in charge, not us.
Should mention, as we're back underway here, the available players as subs for Ottawa. Backup keeper Marcel DeBellis, defender Drew Becky in midfield, Sanisha Ubi-Paripovich and Brandon Poltronieri, Paulo Jr., Ali Alberto Hassan, and Andrew Wiedemann up top. And so I think Ubi-Paripovich, as this ball is shepherded out for a goal kick, Ottawa. You have to think we're going to see Ubi-Paripovich in sometime in the second half in midfield. And maybe we see Paulo Jr. and Ali Alberto Hassan up top.
Well, maybe. I do think Ubi-Paripovich will be here sooner rather than later. I think he might be a halftime change. Phil Davies has been struggling a little bit. It's hard for him. He hasn't played a full game. He hasn't started a game for a long time. So, and it is possible. I don't know. Of course, it's not for my team. But I do think that Phil Davies has been finding it quite hard out wide here on the right.
Davies wins this. Now to Howard. 20 yards from goal. Plays this in for Oliver, and it bounces off his foot and right up his body, so it's going to be a handball, and this will be a free kick for Atlanta Silverbacks, as we're going to get some word from the fourth official how much stoppage time, and it's going to be a minimum of 2 minutes.
At least he shows us how long nowadays, AJ.
Depends on the fourth official. Silverbacks in possession. Trafford able to win this back for Ottawa. Now to Richie Ryan for Oliver. Now to Tom Heineman, who gives away possession way too easily there. Still inside the Ottawa half. So Paul Black plays it wide right. Here's Kimura. The ball towards the penalty area. Bounces into the 18-yard box. Mendez, and taken away here by Richie Ryan, and back comes Ottawa on the counter. Ryan gets this forward for Mauro Iustakiu with some space. Now for Mason Trafford, back to Iustakiu inside the Atlanta half, and this will be an Ottawa throw. About a minute left in stoppage time here in the first half. 0-0. Fury FC in Atlanta. We'll hear from Martin Nash shortly. Get his thoughts at halftime. Assistant manager for Ottawa Fury FC. Down the left it goes. And another throw for Ottawa, one by Howarth. Trafford will take this. Lays it in for Oliver near the corner flag. And oh, Oliver's going to win a corner here. So this looks like it'll be the last kick of the half for Ottawa Fury FC.
They'll be pumping up the big, the tall man will be moving head. Falvey's the tough one, and Alves the tall one. And of course you got Tommy in there with them, so we'll see what happens. I guess it's the skipper taking the kick.
And he's got no ball. Finally, he gets a ball. That's necessary here. So, five players in the penalty area, make it six with Colin Falvey. Left-footed delivery coming from Richie Ryan. It'll be a left-footed outswinger from Ryan. Probably the last action of this first half. Here's the delivery from Richie Ryan, and it's headed into the air, and Seuss has it.
Bit of a messy one.
And that is the halftime whistle from Francis Latulippe. The score, 0-0, Fury and Atlanta. And
we got him.
Let's head downstairs here as we'll be joined by Martin Nash, pitch side. And Martin is with us. Martin, thanks for joining us. Just your thoughts in the opening 45 minutes. All good. Seems like their approach, they're playing a 3-5-2. It seems like they're pretty deliberate in their approach, not to try to press anything. How difficult is that to break down? Substitutions play a very important part again here today with the three matches in 8 days and some key players on the bench like a Sinisa Ubi Perapovic. Martin, thanks for this. Best of luck in the second half. That's Martin Nash, assistant manager for Ottawa Fury FC. All right, there you have it. Your thoughts on the opening 45 minutes, Richard Starnes.
Opening 45, I was a little bit surprised that Martin Nash thought that this was not a bad half. I thought the Fury were not playing it quick enough. They've been playing it much quicker in the last two games, and that's the way to break down defenses when they're three and then they become five. You've got to move the ball fast because then it gives them no chance to get back to join the other defenders. I personally also think that Oliver needs, that there needs to be a closer eye kept on giving the ball to Oliver wide and let him lose his pace and his skill on the ground to beat a man, which he can continuously, and hit those crosses. And yeah, I think they're quite right. They need to have somebody attack in the near post when they're going forwards. So in general, but I would not be surprised to see some changes. As I said just before halftime, Phil Davis is doing fine, and he's trying to get back into the full playing role, having come in as a starter since his injury. I'm not quite sure whether he's playing in the place that I would personally want to put him. I think he might do better in a more central role, and I thought that's what was going to happen with Howarth wide, but it seems that that's the other way around, and maybe we'll see some changes there.
All right. Again, the score at halftime, Ottawa Fury FC 0, Atlanta Silverbacks 0. Coming up, we'll have a look at our halftime stats. Graham Creech will have a TSN 1200 sports update and much more as we're 13 minutes away from the start of second half action here at TD Place. You're listening to Ottawa Fury FC Soccer on TSN 1200.
There are hundreds of faucets to choose from at Preston Hardware. If it's time to design your dream bathroom or just change the taps, then you have to see the Bathroom Design Center at Preston Hardware.
Thank you,
Jen. If you can imagine it, there's a good chance they have it. They carry every type of sink, bath, shower, even a toilet with an automatic seat cover. If your bathroom needs a makeover, visit Preston Hardware's Bathroom Design Center today.
Preston Hardware.
Service, selection, value.
Time for Great Canadian Inventions. In 1927, Guelph Elastic Hosiery invented the hard cup jock strap, allowing hockey players to have baby
possession.
Hockey players.
That's my dad out there. Wow. Well, the miracles of modern
that seems
science.
A little high.
Another
I think
great
that's
Canadian
a
invention,
too.
Just like Arctic Spa's line of energy efficient hot tubs
think,
made in Edmonton.
I think
the fury
of being conceding possession
be
when they're pushing the ball
kind
of about
weather,
in the middle
rain,
of the park
wind,
a lot of the time.
Snow, with Canadian
so
made
I don't
spas
agree with
built
that
from the world's
either.
Finest materials. View their entire ingenious product line at arcticottawa.com.
Police, come out with your hands up.
The fury have been the most likely to score. I've looked
line.
The most likely
your
to score.
Oh, for sure.
Shots,
have they even looked likely
what's
to score? Other than
there?
That one chance,
we're watching investigation
well, 20 yards
discovery.
Out for the guy.
It's all about true life crime.
They're
murder,
not very good.
Mysteries.
Atlanta are not very good.
All summer.
Keep talking.
Who do they have? Who they have? Who
do
they have
that's
any good? Mendez is not a bad player. But I don't think they're strong at the back. I think they're slow and cumbersome.
We've got
good for
just as your
for
shoes
set pieces
your
in the
outfit,
air because
the
they're tall
your
but,
home. Selecting
and
the right flooring is an important decision.
Quite tough.
That's why Athens Rugs wants
but
to add just the right accessory to
I
your home.
Think a very
let us help
side.
You choose the right floor to make your furniture
and I don't,
pop
I think the
and give you room
played
wow
down
factor.
To them rather than them having to play up to the fury.
Today or visit us at Athens Rugs, 1365
get in there, guys. Win a bit more of the ball. Move it faster.
40 years in business.
Those inside the fullbacks passes is what you need.
You stand on our reputation.
We should be the coach.
You're listening to TSN 1200.
Be fun.
It's Ottawa Fury FC Halftime. Halftime on TSN 1200.
Welcome back inside TD Place, about 10 minutes away from the start of second half action as Ottawa Fury FC and Atlanta Silverbacks are scoreless through 45 minutes. Let's have a look at the halftime stats. Ottawa was 60% possession, all three shots on target. Atlanta had two shots off target. I think one of those was the shot that went past the north side stands and towards the restaurants and bars here. It was closer.
Thinking it was going for a Starbucks halfway down Bank Street, quite
yeah,
honestly.
Yeah, it certainly wasn't close to being on target, that one. But two shots off target to one for Ottawa. And corners, the only two coming for Ottawa, one right at the end of the half from Richie Ryan. So Ottawa, the better of the two sides, the more likely to score. But still with still needing to be better if they're going to break down this Atlanta team that looks like they've come here to earn a point on a 0-0 draw.
Yeah, I think the key thing we heard at halftime was that we need to be a little bit quicker with the ball, moving the ball. And if they don't have to be much quicker. If they're a little quicker, they can break down this defense. As we said before the game started, they had three at the back, but Black and Kimura are both actually fullbacks, and as soon as there's any danger, they drop back. It's strange. You can't call it parking the bus, but it almost is. It's parking the bus in the middle of the field by just keeping possession. They really don't look like they've got anybody up front who's got any real threat. So from that standpoint, as long as the back four stand tall, I don't think that's a problem. But they have to find a way of breaking down these guys and maybe even chip, you know, it's not the Ottawa way necessarily, but the chip over the central defenders with quick men to run onto might work. I might even, you know what, I might even try AJ, and I don't expect they will, but I might even try bringing on Poltinieri, who's very quick, and he's a sort of 10-minute burst player who could actually break something open.
Well, we'll see what Ottawa does here in the second half. It's about 8 minutes away. But first, Graham Creech will be back at the TSN 1200 studio with a sports update, and then it will be second half action from TD Place. 0-0 at halftime. Ottawa Fury FC against Atlanta Silverbacks. You're listening to Ottawa Fury FC Soccer on TSN 1200.
There's a clear advantage to Marlboro Windows, like their history, which is important to them.
And it's important that they know they're dealing direct.
Great
no middleman, they can call
her
anytime. We're here. We've been here for 38 years, and we're going to be here for another 38 years.
With so many choices out there, Marlboro Windows' local ties make them the easy one.
They can talk to the owners.
Who shop in Ottawa, who buy here, and their kids are going to grow up in Ottawa.
Marlboro Windows, Ottawa's only local window manufacturer.
Feds
Marlboro Windows.
Contributing paying $1 billion to the LRT, eh?
Who?
The feds.
Imagine the Little Mermaid as a fighter pilot.
Yes.
Okay, I get it. Picture a world where salmon rule the air, where not.
Pass.
Fine. Okay. One word. Shrimpicane.
Pass.
If you want to see one movie this year about airborne fish,
done a hell of a job
make it this
space.
One.
Yeah.
Sharknado 3. Oh, hell no. Tonight at 9.
Not again.
Only on Space.
Clam Cyclone. Clam Clone. Clam Monsoon.
Get out.
Everyone has a go-to guy for something. Your car guy, your hair guy, your tax guy. At Athens Rugs, we want to be your flooring guy, your trusted confidant. Come to us for expert advice from our professionals. We pride ourselves on attention to detail and delivery and installation on time and on budget. Schedule your free in-home consultation today or visit us at Athens Rugs, 1365 Searville Road or at athensrugs.com.
Athens Rugs, your one-stop flooring store.
You stand on our reputation.
Passing through the gates of Lochmarch, you enter your private getaway. A yellow trolley car approaches to bring you and your clubs to the clubhouse. Lochmarch Golf and Country Club is a public course, but with the quality and services of a private club. Lush fairways, breathtaking views, and just minutes from downtown. There are many words to describe an exceptional golf course, but only two words sum it up. Lochmarch, the luxuries of a private club on a public course.
This is TSN 1200 Ottawa. TSN 1200 Sports Center Update.
Good evening, I'm Graham Creech. Brooke Henderson has won the CPGA Women's Championship. Brooke shot a 367 today to finish at minus 8 on the tournament. She wins by 2 strokes on second place. She defends her title that she won as an amateur last year. Some Fury FC news coming off the pitch today as captain Richie Ryan and defender Rafael Alves were named to the NASL Team of the Week. Ryan netted a pair of goals in Sunday's win over Indy, while Alves added 1 strike. Jamaica has defeated the United States 2-1 to advance to its first ever Gold Cup final. They'll meet the winner of Panama, Mexico. Canada picked up more hardware today at the Pan Am Games. Hugo Hull earned a gold in men's road cycling individual time trial, while Jasmine Gleeser won silver in the women's time trial. On water, Whitney McClintock won gold in the women's overall water skiing competition, and Jarrett Llewellyn took silver in the men's overall event. The men's Canadian basketball team leads Argentina 83-80 late in the fourth quarter of their preliminary round game. If Canada hangs on, they'll improve to 2-0. The NBA has announced that the Toronto Raptors will play a regular season game in London, England, against the Orlando Magic this coming season. The Raps and Magic tip off January
14th. Jamaica beat the U.S., eh?
It'll be the sixth regular season game played
today
in London.
Cup.
Toronto Blue Jays continue a three-game series tonight in Oakland. Toronto cruised to a 7-1 victory over the A's last night in Josh Donaldson's return to Oakland. Runs will be harder to come by tonight as the Jays face Athletics ace Sonny Gray. Toronto counters with Felix Dubront. It's a 10:05 first pitch from the Coliseum. Elsewhere among AL East teams, the Tampa Bay Rays have dropped 2 of 3 to the Phillies as Philadelphia takes today's rubber match 5-4 in 10 innings. Elsewhere, the East-leading Yankees lead Baltimore 3-2 in the bottom of the third, and the Red Sox are in Houston at their moments away from opening pitch at Minute Maid Park. Coming up, it's the second half. The score at halftime is Ottawa Fury FC 0, the Atlantic Silverbacks 0. You're listening to Ottawa Fury FC Soccer on TSN 1200.
Into sports, the soccer superstore on
Merivale
Road. Their goal is to serve, inform, and inspire those.
Two, but I can add.
Yeah, add another minute.
Into Sports carries everything from cleats to jerseys and from shin pads to balls. Soccer isn't just a sport, it's a way of life. So dress the part.
Go, 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 go.
Into Sports, 1558 Merivale Road.
Oh, man.
At intosports.ca.
There's a clear advantage to Marlboro Windows. Like their history, which is important to them.
Fury didn't look good.
They know.
I mean, they're just playing it too slow.
No middlemen.
They played two games when they looked strong that way.
We've been here for 38 years, and we're going to be here for another 38 years.
With so many choices out there, Marlboro Windows local ties make them the easy one.
They can talk to the owners.
Why are they playing Wednesday games? Is that they've got some new contract?
Kids are going to grow up in Ottawa.
Marlboro Windows, Ottawa's only local window manufacturer. MarlboroWindows.com.
I think. think.
It's a double dose of Wendy's
Friday
Night Football.
They're playing one a week
football.
Now.
First, it's the Stamps and Red Blacks from the nation's capital. Then the Argos head into the Lions' den.
An absolute beauty!
The action kicks off at 7 on TSN.
And I'm guessing
want to find everything the Canada
they've given
City
us an opportunity
to
try and work out
about
there, which
like no other, it's
I'm
just
expecting
will change
this period. It's given us a little bit of a foot in the game, and I'm very pleased with the way that we've worked the ball. I'd like to create one or two more chances, but the way it's gone in 45, something to build on.
Most teams play a 4-4-2, 4-3-3. You guys elect to go with a 3-5-2. Can you just talk about the formation that you guys play with?
We're changing from the spring season for one or two reasons. Firstly, I think it suits
it's Aaron LeBar from Popeye Supplements. Whether you're trying to increase lean muscle,
secondly,
lose body fat,
I think we get
lower cholesterol,
some more advanced areas
energy,
with our front
protein
two,
plays an
and
essential
pressure
part
inside
of your
the
dietary
box
requirements.
And
at Popeye, our nutritional experts will help you find a protein that best suits your needs and tastes great.
Out that way
choose
at the
from
moment.
Canada's
there's
best selection
a,
of the most
a bit of cat and mouse going on in the central midfield areas with that 3-3. But what we're trying to do is maybe impose our will and our system upon whatever team we play against. First period, I think we gave as good as we got. And I'd like to see maybe one or two of the guys just showing a little bit more endeavour to maybe show some more creation in and around that final third.
Thanks, Coach. Special luck.
You're welcome.
When you start with the best, you're sure to impress.
How did the crowd sound at the end there? Did it sound good?
Sobeys. Yeah, that sounded good when they had like the free kick.
Trim it in his
yeah,
road.
I cranked it up a little bit, so
it sounded good.
The smart shoppers go looking for a deal on a lease takeover. Lease Busters.
I just text you. I don't know if I was supposed to hear that.
I'm Jim Matthews from Lease Busters.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I just turned it up because that's on the same channel as
and it works.
One lease of the crowd. Like, so we got our own crowd mic, but we got one
the Sens
that's
play here.
Also through TV, and so that was on the
Ottawa
TV
Fury.
One. I just. That's why.
TSN.
Okay, cool.
The second half starts now.
Welcome back inside TD Place. AJ Jakubek and Richard Starnes with you. 0-0 through 45 minutes. Ottawa Fury FC taking on the Atlanta Silverbacks. Before we get back to this match, should mention, pass along one other score. Gold Cup semifinals. Jamaica with a big upset. They beat USA tonight 2-1. So Jamaica, the first Caribbean side ever to play in the Gold Cup final. They'll play either, I'm trying to think who Mexico's playing. I forget who Mexico's playing.
El Salvador?
It's not El Salvador.
Panama.
Mexico-Panama, yes.
I think it's Panama.
They beat Costa Rica because of a very dubious penalty in extra time, stoppage time as well. It was 124th minute goal on a penalty that should not have been given, but nonetheless, the U.S. is out of the Gold Cup. Lance Lang from FC Edmonton, one of the top players in the league, playing on that Jamaican side.
Yep, we're nearly ready. I'm hoping that this will be, it has been a little, we've used the word before, dour in this first half. There doesn't seem to have been any real push to push for goals, get things really moving in the middle of the park. Well, yeah, and that goes for both sides. So let's see where we go to from here. This could be, we need an early goal. We need an early Fury goal, and that'll really open the game up.
No changes for either side. Fury FC moving right to left here in the second half towards the supporters section. Their black kits, red and white stripes on their black tops, black shorts, black socks. Silverbacks wearing their white tops with the black and red stripes. White shorts, white socks, moving from left to right here in the second half as we are underway. Silverbacks send this forward. And here's Pedro Mendez, stopped by Falve. Gets it back on the right, and nice diving challenge by Falve. This will be a throw-in for Atlanta.
Terrific tackle. Just the sort of thing young kids should see. That was just perfectly performed.
Now Mendez off the throw-in. Plays this, not sure where he's playing this, but that's going to be a goal kick. It was, I think it was supposed to be a cross, but
I think that ball was trying to join the other one in Joey's.
It was almost hit the corner flag.
So goal kick for Ottawa again. Their 11. Pazier is the keeper. Back four from left to right. Trafford, Falve, Alves, and Richter in midfield. Eustachiou, Ryan, and Davies. Howarth, Heinemann, and Oliver up top in this 4-3-3. Atlanta playing a 3-5-2, which at times is a bit of a 5-3-2. Block and Kimura playing the role as fullbacks. It's almost like they've got a left back, a right back, but then Block and Kimura come back to play even wider than the left back and right back in their defensive three.
Scrappy start to this second half. Let's hope somebody can get the ball, keep the ball on the ground and start moving it. It's long floating balls in both directions and not helping anybody, certainly not the flow of the game.
48th minute, 0-0. Atlanta with a free kick, and they take it quickly just inside the Ottawa half. Rashawn McKenzie, wide right, into the middle for Mensing. He'll play this forward for Paul Black. Trying to spring Jaime Chavez. He hasn't seen a lot of the ball tonight. The two strikers for Atlanta. And this will be a free kick for Ottawa.
Chavez is down, and it's a free kick against his team. I think the referee thought that he was, maybe thought he was trying one on there. I don't know where he was kicking it anyway, because he kicked it about 40 yards back into his own half. It's like he was a Fury defender.
Well, this is a real test for Ottawa. These are always tricky matches. When you play a team that's just playing for a point, can you break them down and get that goal? You get that goal, certainly that'll change the way Atlanta approaches things. They'll need to get one, and that'll certainly open things up a little bit more. But can they get that goal? Can they break down Atlanta?
That's the trick, isn't it? As he was saying at halftime, they bring back the two guys who are sort of closet midfielders into their defensive roles, and suddenly you got five to get by.
Back to the keeper, Pazer. Sends his high into the air. Trafford goes up for the header. It's won by Kimura of Atlanta. Plays it forward. Junior Burgos, 25 yards out. And Trafford able to get it back. Not a great pass from Burgos. Hasn't had a great game for Atlanta. Now Eustachiou for Alves. Forward on the right side. Nice little 1-2. Howarth working it there with Davies, but Davies just couldn't get the return ball as Atlanta counters down the left. Here's the cross towards the penalty area. Richie Ryan in the right spot, the Ottawa captain. And he'll push this forward on the right. Davies. That's chested down by Heinemann, but Atlanta gains possession. Mravec comes to McKenzie. Wide right, Kimura, right at the halfway line. Back into the middle, Mravec. Now to Rashawn McKenzie for Mensing. Central defender for Atlanta here tonight. This 3-5-2. Sent wide right 30 yards out for Kimura. For Burgos. Chips this into the penalty area. And the header there from Chavez, but not a lot of power on it. And that allows Pazier to make the easy save. Mensing wins the header inside the Atlanta half. Now Richie Ryan plays it forward again. A strong header here by Simon Mensing, the Atlanta captain, the German. This comes into the middle for Michael Reed. For Chavez, back into his own half for Issahaku. So again, Atlanta quite comfortable just holding possession inside their own half.
I haven't got anything to say, AJ. This is really
dour.
Dour. Hey, yeah, that's a very Scottish word for you. It is dire at the moment. And what has to happen is that the Fury are going to have to find a way to take charge in the middle of the park.
Ball forward, and Pesaire able to scoop this up for Ottawa. For the left back, Mason Trafford. 52nd minute, 0-0. Reminder that all goals in today's match brought to you by Athens Rugs. Header won by Rashawn McKenzie as he barged over the Ottawa player Oliver, who's down. Richie Ryan, now to Howarth, and now the referee Francis Latulippe blows play down.
Yeah, he got a right elbow. I think from Kimura, but I'm not sure, on the top of his head. His head seems to attract an awful lot of attention from everybody. And that occasion he got an elbow in the face.
He had a nice shiner after taking that boot to the face, which earned a penalty in Minnesota, earned Ottawa a 1-1 draw.
Yeah,
of course, had some nice, not nice for him, but dental work done last year. Courtesy of that late season visit to New York against the Cosmos.
Yeah, I thought he'd broken his nose. Fortunately not.
Heineman is fouled 35 yards from goal. See if Ottawa can do something here with a free kick.
It's a pro tackle by Mensing, who just shoveled Heineman to the ground.
So this is going to be in a dangerous spot, and Phil Davies is over this. Left of center. Davies will deliver with his right foot into the penalty area. Headed on by Falve, but that goes out for a goal kick.
Excellent free kick. That was reminiscent of the one that Ljubi Paripovic hit on the weekend, from which they scored. That was that was a terrific free kick.
Yeah, only difference, Rafael Alves was unmarked, and with the free header was able to score. That one, more difficult header back to goal from Colin Falve. Went out for a goal kick. Fury back in possession here in the 55th minute. Looking to open the scoring here, and we've got another free kick given against Atlanta. Davies is fouled.
Yeah, he took another knock. Huh. Yep, the ball had gone and he was brought down. It's just very bad timing. And probably deliberate.
Once again, about 35 yards from goal. This one go right, aligned with the right side of the 18-yard box. So good position here from the left-footed Richie Ryan to deliver this into the penalty area with six Ottawa players right on the edge of the 18. Whistle goes. Richie Ryan delivers, and it is headed outside the box as Atlanta hits this forward on the right, and they'll just clear this to the halfway line. Well, better stuff here from Ottawa. Ayushtakiu now to Falve. Back to Richie Ryan, and he'll play it back to goal. Pesaire will launch this back into the Atlanta half. Flicked on by Davies. Now to Heineman. Chested down by Davies. Play it wide right, Ryan Richter, right at the halfway line. Ahead for Howarth in the center circle. Back to the captain, Richie Ryan. Now to Oliver on the left. Links up with Mason Trafford. Two defenders on him. Puts it high into the air. Flicked on here towards Howarth by Heineman. In behind the defense. Howarth, left foot, and one goal! It's Carl Howarth showing great patience. First goal of the season. And in the 56th minute, Ottawa Fury FC have the lead.
A Amazing. What a great goal. Terrific goal. They've broken them down at last. And Howarth did a tremendous job because he had the chance, but he didn't have a clear shooting line. He managed to pull the ball back, make the space, and pop it past the Zeus, the big man. So now the Fury are one up, and this could change the game quite dramatically because Atlanta have got to start chasing it now. There's no point if you're losing, you've got to start chasing it. I don't think they've got the firepower of the pace up front to do any of that quick breaking stuff, which some of these not quite so good teams are prone to attempt. This could change how the game work, how the game turns. And there's Mark DeSantos down on the line, making sure his men don't lose their concentration after scoring a goal.
Well, great to see Carl Howarth rewarded with that 56-minute goal. It's brought to you by Athens Rugs. And for Carl Howarth, first of the season, always works so hard, covers so much ground, and he took that beautifully. Just for someone who hadn't scored all season, you'd never know it there. He showed great patience, didn't take it straight away, got it onto his left foot and rocketed it past the keeper, Seuss. So Ottawa with the lead, 1-0, 58th minute. And as you mentioned, this will force Atlanta to press forward for the equalizer.
Yeah, could change this game. It could wake it up. And of course, a Fury win, and a win is a win. But so far, it hasn't been the most stellar performance by anybody.
Here's Mensing, able to skip past Tom Heineman into the Ottawa half. Good ball down the right as he picks out Kimura, and this is going to lead to a corner as Mason Trafford plays it out for an Atlantic corner. This will be an opportunity for them to get one back straight away.
Yeah, there'd been some thought that as a left back, Mason Trafford didn't have enough pace. Well, he never lets himself get too far out of position. And that on that occasion, tremendous tackle. He didn't let his man get away, refused to.
Left-footed in-swinger coming in on this corner from Paul Black. Here's the delivery, and it's headed clear. As Atlanta will send this back towards the edge of the penalty area, headed away by Ryan Richter. Right-footed drive from 30 yards out, and that skips wide for a goal kick.
Didn't look dangerous, but you can see that now that Atlanta are going to have to start pushing ahead, pushing forwards. Even Mensing was pushing forward, the central defender, the captain, trying to get his team G'd up to pull a goal back and get back in this game.
A keeper. Pazer will take this goal kick in the 60th minute with Fury leading 1-0. First place in the NASL fall season up for grabs for Ottawa this evening. Can they hang on to it? It's Mensing able to dribble past Tom Heineman dangerously as the last man.
Yeah, I think that was a pretty foolish thing to try. Only got to lose the ball and he's gone.
Kimura into the middle, Mravec. Wide left for Black. Now to Mravec. 1-2 with Black. Plays it back to the left back, Isahaku. Now to Mravec. Isahaku picks out Mendez. Wide left. Into the penalty area they come, and oh, it's a penalty. Rafael Alves called for the penalty. Paul Black went down.
You could see he was looking for that as he came into the box, desperately looking for it. Get another look at it.
It's actually Ustakiu. That's pretty soft.
Yeah, that was pretty soft. was soft. Now we need a Pezzer save, right? That's what we need out of this.
Well, we saw one last week.
Reed's the only real danger man that I've seen there. Yeah, he was looking for the penalty. It was soft. He did touch him. Some refs would call it, some refs would not.
Call it Falvey having a word with the referee. It's going to be Junior Burgos taking this penalty for Atlanta in the 62nd minute. Ball on the spot. Referee blows. Junior Burgos steps up, right foot, and he scores. 62nd minute goal from Junior Burgos. And we've got a 1-1 tie.
Yeah. Unfortunate, they haven't looked like they were going to get anywhere near scoring. We did know that they'd start trying pushing forward, but it was a little bit of a soft touch, I think. But he was looking for the penalty. He was definitely looking for, he was looking to be brought down. He leant into it. The foot was out. Tough decision, but it's 1-1, and I'm quite sure that the Fury will not like that.
So back to square one for Ottawa Fury FC. That 62nd minute goal from the spot. Junior Burgos scores for Atlanta, and we're tied 1-1. Rafael Alves. Wide right for Ryan Richter. Sends this forward, Richie Ryan. Gets it ahead on the right side. Now it's towards Carl Howarth. And Atlanta gains possession. It's Chavez. Back to the central defender, Mensing. To the keeper, Seuss. And plays this high into the air, chested down by Eustachiou. Atlanta wins possession here, right at the halfway line. Eustachiou, a very aggressive player.
Yeah.
Which leads to him winning a lot of balls, but he gives away some fouls. And even though that was maybe not a stonewall penalty, here's Heineman now outside the penalty area. Leaves it Richie Ryan trying to chip this wide right, but it's uncharacteristic from Ryan giving away possession like that.
Idea was good, execution poor, which is for Richie Ryan, doesn't often get said.
65th minute, 1-1, and we are going to see our first substitution of the match here shortly as Ali Alberto Hassan is right at the touchline next to the fourth official, waiting to be subbed in.
First chance to see how what he can do for this club.
There's Richie Ryan now for Howarth. Tom Heineman, halfway line, wide right, Ryan Richter. Cuts into the middle, lays it off for Howarth. Now Eustachiou, wide right for Richter. To Mauro Eustachiou. Sends this forward, Phil Davies. The ball in to the middle for Carl Howarth, the Ottawa goal scorer. Howarth, it was caught from behind. It's a good challenge there as Atlanta wins it back.
Could just have easily gone the other way. Could have actually got right through there. Good effort.
Oh, now Heineman wins possession for Ottawa. 25 yards out and doesn't get much on that shot. With the four defenders near him, and Seuss has possession now for Atlanta.
There's absolutely no doubt, AJ, that the coaching staff know all about Tom Heineman, and they've been keeping a really tight eye on him. And the second half, we haven't really seen very much of him. He hasn't had much of the ball, much opportunity.
Falvey wins a header just outside the Ottawa penalty box, and now Howarth caught by a high boot. And that'll be a free kick for Ottawa Fury FC just inside their own half. Howarth has taken some knocks tonight as Ali Alberto Hassan will be substituted in and he'll replace Tom Heineman in the middle. So, second appearance for Ali Alberto Hassan, the striker.
Again, Heineman did a lot of good running tonight, and he probably needs a bit of a break. He's played some really good games, and he's put in an awful lot of energy and effort. Didn't score tonight, but he's the man who's sort of started the goal-scoring spark.
Free kick, Ottawa, chested down here by Ali Alberto Hassan. And it comes wide right for Richter. Now to Eustachio in the middle. Oh, able to beat one man, gets it for Hassan. Trying to spring Howarth on the right, just outside the penalty area, but defended well, and Atlanta has it. 68th minute, 1-1.
Still all to play for here, and the Fury need to be stepping it up, and they need to bringing in they'll probably bring in somebody else. Maybe Yubi Paripovic, I would guess, I'm not sure. But they do need to, they need those discerning balls through the middle and putting a bit more speed into the way they play in the game.
Second substitution coming here for Ottawa Fury FC, and in comes Anisha Ubi Paripovic into midfield, replacing Canadian Phil Davies.
Straightforward swap. He'll come and play where he normally plays, and Howarth will go wide on the right. Let's see what he can do with his magic feet.
So that an expected change, really. Ubi Paripovic on the bench. I mean, he's a veteran player, and with 3 matches in 8 days, giving him the first 3 quarters of this match on the bench. With an eye on Sunday against Carolina. Fury in possession right now. Eustachio to Ryan Richter. Oh. Good ball forward, but Howarth just a shade offside on that one. And he got in behind the Atlanta defense.
Yep, Atlanta defense actually did quite well there. They stepped up. He was going the other way, and he was offside.
And here's the first substitution for Atlanta. Coming on is Shaka Bangura. And this will be it for Pedro Mendez. He's already on a yellow card.
Sensible move. He's a forward. He's somebody who's going to be looking for a goal, I guess. Not so sure what sort of player he is. If he's got a bit of pace, it would make a difference.
Native of Sierra Leone. Ball in the center circle, chested down by Atlanta, but Fury FC gained possession. Richie Ryan, wide left. Mason Trafford ahead for Oliver. First touch, plays it forward. Here's Ubi Paripovic, his first touch of the match, and it's played. Left-footed shot here, Hassan, he stopped, and oh, it's cleared for a throw-in. Wow, great work by Ubi Paripovic. Hassan, with the half volley, able to get that on target, and a nice save by Seuss.
Good effort.
Fury working back here. Ryan Richter with the cross into the penalty area, chested down and sent forward on the right for Jaime Chavez. 71st minute here at TD Place, 1-1 the score. Eustachio heads this out for an Atlanta throw inside the Ottawa half.
Good effort by Ali Alberto Hassan. That was not an easy shot. The ball came over, he hit it on the half volley. It's a good save, but scramble in front of goal could have gone either way.
Silverbacks push it back to their back three, a 3-5-2 that they're playing, and now the keeper Seuss outside of his box moves it forward for the left back, Isahaku, for Mravec. Now Isahaku, back to the keeper Seuss. Now he's pressured here by Hassan, and he's forced to play this out for a throw-in, so that's what happens when you get a little too cute. Now he slipped on the throw-in. It comes back to the edge of the penalty area. Fury trying to win this inside the 18-yard box. Hassan, and a penalty is given. It's a handball against Atlanta. So Ottawa able to earn a penalty themselves, and they've got a chance to regain the lead in the 72nd minute.
Oh, they're furious. And now Captain Mensing is getting a yellow card. He's absolutely livid. And he gave Richie Ryan a big poke in the stomach as he went by him.
So Simon Mensing in the book. And it's going to be Richie Ryan stepping up to the spot, looking to give Ottawa the lead.
Was a handball. You see that? I saw that was a handball. Man's hand was here. I don't know who it was, but his hand was there. It was open.
So here we go, 73rd minute. Richie Ryan places the ball in the spot. Referee blows his whistle. Ryan steps up left foot, and he hits it! Penalty, Richie Ryan! Ottawa back in the lead, 2-1. 73rd minute, third goal in two matches for the captain.
Tremendous. And I tell you who needs a lot of credit for that, and that's the new man in his first game for the Fury, Ali Alberto Hassan. Working, harrying, hustling, made a difference. He made a difference, and he was partially responsible for that. His first the half volley shot that almost went in, then tussling for the ball and creating the trouble for Atlanta that caused the handball. Richie Ryan's another goal for Richie Ryan. Is he now the leading goal scorer?
No, Tom Heineman's got four. Richie Ryan's got three, though. So he's number two. He had one last year.
He's the first to tell you that he doesn't score goals, but he's putting in a lie to that.
The Irish Beckham.
Well, I don't think he'd quite believe that, but he's, what can you say? He always plays that skipper role, doesn't he? He's just good at it.
So that goal in the 73rd minute from the spot, Richie Ryan, the captain, giving Ottawa the 2-1 lead. It's brought to you by Athens Rugs. We're now in the 75th, and Atlanta trying to answer back. Goals, goals, goals here at TD Place in the fall season. We didn't see many the spring season.
Isn't it wonderful? I love it. And now's the time when the Fury have got to stay calm and focused, because their opposition is going to have to come at them, and that'll create spaces at the back. And I have a suspicion that Ali Alberto Hassan has quite a bit of pace, and give him the chance, he can probably get behind them.
Five goals in 10 matches in the spring season for Ottawa, 9 goals in 4 matches in the fall season. And that's why right now they're about 15 minutes away from potentially being top of the league. This is going to be set out for an Atlantic corner. Bangura went down. He was looking for another call, but referee Francis Latulippe says no.
That was Eustachio again. Did you see that? It was Eustachio who went in with the last tackle. And that time, it was beautifully timed. But all the big men are up.
Yeah, they've got 6 players in the penalty area. For this corner, a left-footed delivery from Black and headed away by Rafael Alves, and he pumps his fist. He made no mistake there. And again, Alves with a strong header outside the penalty area as Atlanta forced to regroup in the center circle. Comes all the way back to Michael Reed. Launches this forward, high into the air. Falve goes up for it, but it takes a bounce and right to the keeper, Pazair.
Interesting that Michael Reid got it at the back there and took too long. He gave, saying they had time to get themselves rearranged, but so did the defense. So to the Fury's advantage that he took longer than he should to pump it back into the box.
Here's Stockhue for Ryan. Gets this into the air and bounces nicely for Ubi Perapovic, 30 yards out. Quick little 1-2. Ubi Perapovic just a step away from maybe taking a shot in space from 20 yards out, but Ottawa still in possession. Not a good ball from Richter on the right, and comes to Kimura. He sends this high into the air into the Ottawa half. Chested down for Bangura, but ball won by Falve. Bangura gets it back, 25 yards out. Oh, another great challenge by Rafael Alves. Just a rock in central defense here in this second half. The Brazilian, as Ottawa works it forward, Ubi Perapovic skipped past a couple of men, plays this wide right, but stepping up. A very important tackle there by Isahaku, otherwise Ottawa was clear on goal.
Ubi Perapovic showing, as he said, his twinkling toes. He beat two, three men, and almost an inch perfect pass to put his man away.
Ball goes out for an Atlanta throw in the 78th minute. 2-1, Ottawa Fury FC leading Atlanta Silverbacks, who are going to make their second substitution of the match. Coming out is Junior Burgos, the man who scored from the spot. And coming in is Paulo Mendez into midfield.
That's Pedro's brother.
Pedro was substituted earlier.
Well, the game has certainly livened up, AJ. I'm happy to say from the spectator's point of view.
Yeah, night and day. Well, we knew it was going to change when Ottawa scored a goal, because Atlanta forced to play a different style.
You're right.
And down a goal again, 2-1 Fury. 79th minute. As Atlanta pushes this down the left, but forced back into their own half. Here's Mensing. Wide right for Rashawn McKenzie. Now to Mravec. Long ball into the air. Short of the penalty area. Headed away by Ottawa's Ryan Richter. Ali Alberto Hassan goes after it. Comes back to Eustachiu. Now to Richie Ryan. Plays this into the air. Chested down by Hassan. Back to Richter. Wide on the right for Howarth. Comes back to Ryan Richter into the middle. Ubi Perapovic, good ball for Hassan. Down the right, 25 yards out. He'll stop it. Plays it for Howarth into the middle. Carl Howarth outside the penalty area. Chips it on. Here's the shot from Ubi Perapovic, and it's parried away by the keeper, Seuss. Good football there from Ottawa Fury FC, and they've earned a corner.
Terrific, terrific play. And doing just what we hoped they would do. Great ball from Howarth. And Ubi Perapovic almost scored. But what they were doing is what we were hoping they were going to do. Suddenly, they increased the speed with which they're moving the ball. And it is not an easy task for Atlanta to hold them off. And that is exactly what they should have been doing and what they are doing. Ubi Perapovic has made a difference coming on. Definitely, and so is Ali Alberto Hassan, who has got some pace and is good at running into space, going wide, pulling people out of position. It's quite encouraging.
Michal Mravec was down in the penalty area, got some attention, but he's back up and good to go. So this will be an 81st minute corner for Ottawa. Sinisha Ubi Perapovic, who's been very lively off the bench for Ottawa, will take this. It'll be a right-footed outswinger, but not before we've got another substitution here. As out comes Michal Mravec. It's 16 on the board, but it's going to be 6 coming on Josh Hughes. It's the third and final substitution for Atlanta. 16 on the lineup card, and number 6, Josh Hughes, comes on. Here is the corner, right-footed outswinger. Ubi Perapovic takes a bounce in the penalty area. Alves trying to get a leg on that, and now Richie Ryan is bundled over by Bangura. Referee says play on. Goes near the corner flag. Alves, good footwork, but can't keep this in play. It goes past the byline. Goal kick, Atlanta, 82nd minute, 2-1 Fury. Silverbacks get this towards the halfway line. There's the first touch from the newcomer Hughes. Now to Mensing. Wide right, McKenzie. Plays this high into the air. Dealt with by Rafael Alves. Flicked on by Ubi Perapovic. Towards Howarth. It goes to the far touch line. And back comes Atlanta. Reed down the left. Hughes. Back to Isahaku. Captain Mensing. Play it right along the halfway line. Right back, McKenzie. Here's Kimura. Moves this into the middle. Hughes for Kimura. Ooh, nice little spinorama there to get away from Oliver. Couldn't find any room in front of him, though. Comes back to Reed. Toe pokes this into the penalty area. Bangura shot. And right in the path of goal was Mason Trafford. Keep it off target. Kimura, 25 yards out. Comes into the middle and not a great ball from Paulo Mendez. Rolls along the turf. And the keeper pays there, has it. But Atlanta showing some danger here in the 83rd minute. 2-1 Fury. And they're set to bring on their third and final substitution, Paulo Junior, waiting at the touchline next to the fourth official. He'll be the third and final sub for Ottawa. Atlanta's used their three. Launched high into the air into the Atlanta half. Mendez, rather Hassan with the touch, but got away from him. And Kimura has it for Atlanta. Comes into the middle, Reed. Inside the Atlanta half. Now to Kimura. Wide right into the Ottawa half for Mendez. Back to Reed. Wide left into space. And running onto it is Isahaku. Now to Paul Black. To Isahaku. Center circle for the captain, Mensing. Wide right. Kimura. Marking him as Oliver. Good ball into the middle, 25 yards out. Comes to Bangura. Into the penalty area now. Back into the middle, Mendez a shot and he misses high. And it'll be a goal kick, Ottawa, 85th minute. And that'll allow the third and final sub for Ottawa. Off comes Oliver and he'll be replaced, the Brazilian, by another Brazilian up front in Paulo Junior.
Yeah, Paulo Junior will undoubtedly play a bit of that role that he's been playing in the last game or two. Doing a lot of running, pushing forward. He's got 7 minutes and he's got lots of spring in the legs, and I'm sure he'll be doing good work on a defensive side of things as well as the attacking side.
Rafael Alves, he's had another strong match here tonight for Ottawa as he clears that out of touch.
Yeah, I think his head is a ball magnet. He's a tall man, but he's really good in the air. Really good.
Into the 86th minute. Lana pushing forward past the halfway line. Here's Mendez. Oh, gives up possession. Ali Alberto Hassan. Out of Carl Howarth, who just never seems to tire. And it's going to be called for a foul here.
No, Howarth is the ever-ready bunny, I think. Howarth, he never seems to run out of gas. A little bit slower by the end of the game, but not much.
Once again, the supporters groups, full voice, yelling, "South side, stand up." The ball is won here by Ottawa Fury FC. Short of the halfway line, Ali Alberto Hassan. Now to Ubi Perapovic. Wide right, Howard. Plays it back for Ryan Richter. The ex-Toronto FC player, out of Ubi Parapovic. Also has MLS experience in New York and Montreal. And he's going to win a free kick here in a dangerous spot about 25 yards out.
Very silly giveaway by the Silverbacks. It was an unnecessary thing to do, and I don't know. I think they're beginning to lose their cool a little bit. I think that was Mensing again, the skipper, and I think he was mad about the penalty, which was a penalty given against them. But it's tough. It's tough when you're struggling, and they have been struggling, and they've been on a long road trip. So hard task for Atlanta.
Ubi Parapovic will take this free kick, lays it off for Richie Ryan short, back to Ubi Parapovic into the middle, acres of space for Mauro Eustachiu. Now to Mason Trafford, he'll push forward to Ali Alberto Hassan, edge of the penalty area, Mendez, or rather Mensing, able to win it, and he's fouled, so free kick deep in the Atlanta half for the Silverbacks. Got the two big bald heads messed up there in Mendez and Mensing. How could a baldy like me screw up a couple of baldies on the pitch?
I don't know, they're the same height. They play most of the time at the different ends of the field, but they're both the same sort of size. And let's face it, they're taller than you.
That just ruins the stereotype that I like to say we don't all look alike, you know.
I'm not saying a word. I don't really want to get involved in that. I've never been one of those who doesn't have hair. There we go.
Fury FC win it here as we approach the 89th minute. 2-1 Fury. Goals from Richie Ryan from the spot and Carl Howarth. Richie Ryan has it right now.
Very cool by Ryan. That was a poor pass from Pedro Jr. Paolo Jr. It just... you can't do those slow-moving passes, cross-field passes in your own half. It's asking for trouble.
So they give up possession, and now it's Rashawn McKenzie towards the halfway line for Kimura. Now to Hughes, to Kimura. Just inside the Ottawa half, but forced back by Paolo Jr. Gives it to McKenzie, into the middle, Mensing, the captain. Wide left, a little more space here for Isahaku, and he'll work it into the Ottawa half, 35 yards out. Plays it into the penalty area, Bangura, but dealt with nicely by Falve. Down the right, it comes to Richter. He'll send this forward, and this will be a throw in the Atlanta half for the Fury as we're now into the 90th minute. Can they see off these remaining minutes?
Are we going to be
earn top spot in the NASL fall season?
Just about to say that. Are we going to be able to say that?
Well,
the odds look good.
Ball for Ubi Parapovic, bounces off him, and Atlanta get possession back. They move it wide right, Kimura. Marked here by Paolo Jr. Plays this high into the air towards Bangura. Header won by Falve. Real strong header there by Colin Falve. Ubi Parapovic now to Hassan. Three defenders back. 30 yards out, Ali Alberto Hassan. Is he gonna give this a go? Now he works it onto his right foot, the shot, and it deflects out of touch. Past the byline, corner coming for Ottawa as we now enter stoppage time, and we'll see from the fourth official how much we have. It's 4 minutes, a minimum of 4 minutes to be played here at TD Place.
Quite impressed with the first real sighting of Ali Alberto Hassan. He's got some pace. He's got some. He appears to have confidence.
Here he take this short on the corner, and they win a throw as Howarth played it to Ubi Parapovic. Throw still deep in the Atlanta half. Howarth will take this. Actually, no, he'll leave this here. It'll be taken by Ryan Richter. Atlanta wins it back near the corner flag. Sent forward and Atlanta able to keep it in play. Comes to Mensing, moves it forward, but now this goes out for another Ottawa throw. Might not be pretty to watch, but effective from Ottawa. They're just trying to keep Atlanta hemmed in their own half, and finally the Silverbacks able to win a goal kick. And a couple of minutes of stoppage time have already passed as Seuss plays this to his left back, Isahaku. Moves this into the middle. It comes to Reed. Center circle. Wide right for McKenzie. Chests this down. Just short of the halfway line. Now to the Ottawa half for Kimura. Back to McKenzie. Ottawa pressing here. Trying to keep Atlanta far away from goal. And Richter wins a header as it bounces in the center circle. Mensing gets it back for Atlanta.
Bit lucky, Mensing actually almost went over his head. That could have caused real trouble for Alberta, for the Silverbacks.
Kimura still at the halfway line for Atlanta. Ahead for Bangura. Now they're 30 yards from goal. And Falve is going to be called for a free kick. He doesn't like the call. And is this Atlanta's opportunity here with about 3 minutes played of stoppage time?
I think they'll put 11 men in the box. I think they should put the goalie in the box. He's the tallest by far. And they've got a whole ton of men in the box, and they're going to hit that curling one in towards the far post, is my guess.
Paul Black over this free kick, 30 yards out, right of goal. Black delivers into the penalty area, headed towards goal, and Pizarre able to make the save. It was headed towards goal by Bangura, and Romuald Pizarre holds on. Is that the final stop he'll have to make for Ottawa this evening as he rolls it forward, right side. Ryan Richter sends this high into the air, looking for Paolo Junior. It bounces, and Seuss able to get to it as we are very close to the full-time whistle. Atlanta, do they have one more offensive attack in them as they push this to Bangura into the penalty area, but the offside flag is up. And that might be it for Atlanta this evening. Pizarre is stretching now in the 6-yard box.
Got cramp.
But, it looks like he's gonna be okay. As we have played 4 minutes of stoppage time. It's just up to the referee now as Pizarre pushes the ball forward. And he will step up and kick this deep into the Atlanta half with his right foot. Hassan goes up for it, able to win it. And free kick given against Hassan as Atlanta has it in their half, and they push everyone forward. Hassan's gonna have to push back 10 yards to avoid a free kick as it's taken short to the keeper, Seuss. And there's the final whistle. Ottawa Fury FC win it 2-1 over Atlanta this evening. And for the first time in club history, Fury, top of the league in NASL.
Wow, I think it's a wow moment. What a terrific, it was a battling win. They came at it, they didn't play as well as they might, but they managed to eke out a win. Good goals, good substitutions. And in the end, there we go. They are top of the league. I love to say that.
So big 2-1 win this evening. Richie Ryan and Carl Howarth with the goals. And Fury on 10 points lead the fall table. And hey, they're only 1 point back of the overall lead as well on 21 points this season. It's amazing how tight things are in the North American Soccer League. Just 10 points separate top from bottom in the overall table, and they're right there. They're one back.
They'll be further ahead. They'll be in front by the end of Sunday. They'll be in front.
AJ, tied with the New York Cosmos and one back of Tampa Bay. So
yep,
it's pretty exciting
once
stuff.
The weekend's out, that'll be it. It is exciting.